Did you know that you can use Botox in your bladder? Well, actually you can. I'm Dr. Rena Malik, urologist and pelvic surgeon, and today we're gonna talk all about how you can use Botox for overactive bladder. If you're new here and you like this content, make sure you subscribe and share this channel with your friends. Also, give this video a thumbs up because it really helps other people find my content. So it's true, we inject Botox for patients who struggle with urinary urgency, the sensation that you have to go to the bathroom but you can't delay, urinary frequency, meaning go to the bathroom more than 8 times a day, or having accidents related to urgency, gotta go, and can't make it, or waking up at night more than once. Also used for patients who have what we call neurogenic bladder. This is often patients who have spinal cord injuries, multiple sclerosis, Parkinson's, strokes, diabetes, other things that can affect the contractions of the bladder so that they are too strong, or if their bladder becomes more stiff over time and can't stretch well, and that increase in pressure can create problems for your kidneys. And this is because the bladder is essentially connected to the kidney by two tubes called the ureters. And typically a bladder is like a balloon. It fills and stretches super easily. But when patients have nerve injuries to their bladder, that balloon or the wall of the bladder becomes very stiff. When you fill the bladder, instead of it stretching easily, it becomes a high pressure situation. And so the urine from the bladder either needs to leak out or it will go backwards up to the kidneys. And over time, this can affect the function of the kidneys, which is a real problem. And so for those patients, Botox can be really important. And it works essentially just like it does for wrinkles on the face. It paralyzes the bladder muscle. So you have less strong contractions of the bladder muscle. And those are the contractions that make you feel the urge to urinate. How effective is it? Well, about 80% of people who get Botox injections have relief of their symptoms, whether it's having less accidents, going less often to the bathroom, having less strong urges to go to the bathroom, or waking up less at night. You show up to the office and then you get undressed from the waist down. Afterwards, we'll have you put your legs up into stirrups and we'll insert some numbing jelly into the urethra and some numbing medication into the bladder. That will sit there for somewhere between 10 and 20 minutes before we do the actual injection so that the numbing medication has some time to work. After which we go in with a cystoscope or a camera that looks in the bladder. That's connected to a specialized needle, which is what we use to inject the Botox. Generally, people will get somewhere between 10 and 30 injections of Botox into the wall of the bladder and spread out over the entire wall of the bladder. Usually it feels like small bee stings, but some people do have more pain with injections. But I would say that 90% of people can do it in the office without a problem. This part takes about 10 minutes. After it's done, you'll want to hang out in the office for about 30 minutes when we make sure that you can urinate after the Botox has been injected and that you don't have any issues. Afterwards, you might have some discomfort when you urinate, especially for the first few times. You can also have blood in the urine or light pink tinge to urine, and that's completely normal and expected. If that pain or discomfort continues after you get those injections for more than a day or so, you want to talk to your doctor about maybe getting treatment for a urinary tract infection. Also, your doctor will make sure that you can urinate, but if you start noticing that you're having any difficulty urinating after the procedure, call your doctor as well. And the reason is those are the two most common complications associated with Botox. One is getting urinary tract infections, and two is not being able to empty your bladder well. This happens in about 5%, so 5 out of 100 people who get Botox injections will have difficulty emptying their bladder, and they may need to catheterize themselves afterwards. Lastly, this procedure only lasts for about 6 to 9 months before you have to get Botox injected again because it does wear off. Pros is that it works, and pretty quickly. It works in about 3 to 7 days after getting the injection. Some people it takes up to 2 weeks, but I would say the large majority of patients see improvement pretty quickly. And lastly, it's minimally invasive. You don't need anesthesia, you don't need a ride, you don't need to go through preoperative paperwork or anything like that to get this procedure done. Cons for this procedure are that you do need to have repeat procedures, so maybe up to twice a year you'll be coming to the office to get Botox injections. And second is that you may have a small chance chance of not being able to urinate, in which case you need to feel comfortable learning how to catheterize your bladder. If this is something you want to learn about, comment below and let me know so I can make a video on how you catheterize yourself. Lastly, if you are not willing to catheterize yourself or you think you might have a UTI, make sure you tell your doctor because you shouldn't get Botox then. I hope this was helpful. Make sure you check out my Overactive Bladder playlist where I go through other options that you can do at home to help your overactive bladder as well as other treatment options. As always, I'm going to take care of yourself because you're worth it.